Hi and welcome to my channel. I'm Zoe and today I'm going to be talking about some of my favorite shows that are on Netflix right now. And so most of them are Netflix originals. There are a few that aren't, but so yeah, let's get into it. So the first show that I'm going to talk about is On My Block, and it was recently just added to Netflix. And it's really good, so I just finished watching it, and it's about, this group of friends in California, and their neighborhood is kind of, filled with crime and gang violence, and it's essentially just about their lives and being teenagers and being freshmen in high school. And almost the entire cast, is made up of people of color, which is really amazing because most shows there, you know, a few people of color, there'll be your black kid and an Asian kid and that's it, and everyone else is white. So for there to be a show with 90% of the cast being people of color is really groundbreaking for TV, for children of color to see a TV show with kids that look like them is really amazing. I just want to say that all of the links for the trailers of these TV shows are going to be down below in the description box. So the next show is The End of the Effing World. I don't want to give too much away, but essentially there's this boy who thinks that he can't feel anything, thinks that he can't feel any emotions. And he meets this girl and they go on an adventure together. And some crimes are committed. I don't want to give too much away so that you know what's going to happen at the end. So that's all I'm going to say. Then the third show is Cable Girls. This show is a Spanish show. So it's all in Spanish, but you can change the captions on the bottom in English, or you can have it spoken in English, like you can change what the language is, but I personally don't like to do that because it doesn't sound authentic. So this girl, Alba, she left her hometown with this boy, Francisco, and I think they go to Madrid. Oh, I might be so wrong about this. I cannot remember anything. And they, Alba goes missing, like Francisco can't find her. And essentially, like, I think 10 or 15 years later, Francisco meets this girl, this other girl, and he marries her, and she's very wealthy, and they have a telephone company. And so Alba has to go to this telephone company to steal money from the telephone company, and it's kind of the relationship between Alba and Francisco and them reconnecting, and you know, there's a little bit of other drama and romance that happens as well in the show. Okay, the next show is another foreign TV show. It's called Lovebird. It's Turkish, and oh my gosh, okay, it's a bit weird just because two characters that fall in love are cousins, but, you know, kissing cousins, a little weird. But because it takes place in like I think the 1800s, it's not as weird back then or anyway. Like it wouldn't be considered weird then, but now it's like really weird. But it's actually a really sweet TV show. It's in Turkish, and once again, you have to read the captions, the closed captioning, and but it's really good. And it's about this girl, it's called Lovebird, I don't know if I said that, but the reason that it's called Lovebird is because that's what they call the girl. I don't know how to say it in Turkish, it's like Kelkusku or something. I probably butchered that, sorry. And she's an orphan, and so she spends time with this family, and she falls in love with her cousin. But it's a good show, I mean. Don't get turned off by that fact, which is kind of weird, but you know, it's a good show. But the fifth show is Dark. And Dark is a German TV show. It's one of the, it's the first German show to be on Netflix. And this one's the weirdest out of all of them. And you think, you know, Kissing Cousins is a bit weird. But this is the weirdest because you're not sure when it's all taking place. Just because three generations are shown in the TV show. And they're all connected, and you're not sure if the time period that is in the present is actually the present or the future or the past. It's a bit confusing. But anyway, a boy goes missing right after the father of another child, commits suicide. And the boy goes missing and he goes into the past. So it's a little weird, but it's very interesting. There's the sixth show is Dear White People. And so this show was actually first a movie, and that's the first thing that I'd watched. And it is so funny, honestly. So it's essentially about this biracial girl at a college, and she has like this radio show called Dear White People, and she essentially explains everything that like white people are doing wrong, I guess, like appropriating culture, or saying, oh, I'm not racist because I have a black friend. And so yeah, she discusses those issues and those topics on her show, and there's a little bit of drama and love as well. So, my seventh show is Everything Sucks. So this one is another like teen drama, I guess, and it takes place in the 90s. Yeah, in the 90s, and it's just about high school, you know, being in high school, and high school is kind of hard, and that's essentially what it's about. The characters make a movie as well, so that's like a second theme of the TV show. There's a lot of love and romance, and you know, figuring out who you are as a person, your identity, but it's really good. It's another high school drama, and as I am in high school, those shows are very, they're like reflective, I guess, of my life. No, I feel like that's wrong. I feel like that's the wrong word to explain it. But it's very similar to, you know, life in high school, because most of the cast are like teenagers, which is amazing because in most TV shows you have like 35-year-olds playing a 15-year-old, which is really weird. Next show that I have on my list is Anne. So this is a Canadian TV show, but it's owned by Netflix, and it's about Anne of Green Gables, which was one of my favorite books as a child. I mean, I still have one, but when I was really little, I loved Anne of Green Gables. If you don't know the story of Anne of Green Gables, it's about a girl who is an orphan, and this brother and sister are looking for a boy to adopt to work on their farm, and The orphanage thinks that they're looking for a girl, so they send Anne. And the brother and sister are kind of in shock. They're like, oh, this is not what we asked for. They're a bit confused why they have this little redheaded girl instead of a boy. But Anne doesn't want to leave them, and the brother and sister begin to care for her, and they decide not to send her back, and they keep her. And it's essentially, the show is essentially just about her adventures. If you've read the books, it's kind of similar to that, but there's an added twist to it in the last two episodes. It's a little different than the books. The second to last show is 21 Thunder. This is another Canadian show. As I was saying, practically none of these shows are really American. But this show is about a soccer team, a made-up soccer team in Montreal called Montreal Thunder, and it's about the 21 under team. That's why it's called 21 Thunder. And it's about their lives and it's about the soccer players' lives, their relationships with their families, the coaches' lives, what's going on in their lives. It's really good. And it's beyond just soccer. And my last show that I want to talk about is Alias Grace. This show takes place in Canada, and oh my god, it's so confusing at first, but it's really good. Actually, it's not that confusing. It's just kind of, you have to think a little bit, and it kind of makes you think and question, because there's this girl, Grace, who is an Irish immigrant, and it's believed that she has committed a murder. She committed a murder when she was a child. That's what's believed. And they have this therapist, I think his name is Dr. Jordan, and he comes and he talks to her about the murder, trying to figure out if she actually committed it. And it's a bit weird, actually. Like, how she... I'm not gonna say if she committed it. But how the murder was committed was a bit weird. It was a bit odd. That is the last show. So those are my top 10 Netflix TV shows. Hopefully you haven't heard of any of these shows and would be willing to watch them, because they are all really good. And once again, all of the links for the trailers will be down below. So before you leave, like, subscribe, comment, and thank you for watching. It means a lot to me.